First up, Venezuela.
Yes, it's politically unstable. But if your main concern is biodiversity and how much natural land a nation protects, Venezuela leads the way. More than half of the country is a national parkland or a UNESCO-designated biosphere reserve. And here's the UK by comparison. The USA, by the way, comes in 124th place.
Number two on this list, but number one in my heart, aww, is, where are we? Bhutan.
Nestled in the Himalayas, this Buddhist kingdom is the world's only carbon-negative country, absorbing four times more CO2 than it emits. Because tourism is so regulated here, those that pay a premium to visit are totally immersed into a welcoming culture and community with few barriers between the Bhutanese and you. For the past 47 years, the country's also measured progress, not by gross domestic product, but gross national happiness. Way ahead of the curve.
Following Bhutan, number three on the list is, let me tilt it, Slovenia.
It may be small, but it punches above its weight in the land conservation stakes.
Okay, side note, my mum, who was born in the former Yugoslavia, she actually told me when she was going there as a kid on school trips, she was impressed at how clean and how green Slovenia was. So I think conservation has been in their culture for a very long time.
Today, 53% of its land has formal protections.
Number four is somewhere in Asia, Cambodia.
Again, a few question marks around its leadership. But putting that to one side, sustainable travel isn't only about the environment. Cambodia makes the cut for the brilliant charity work of some of the hotels there. Shintamani supports a training school educating students from disadvantaged backgrounds. Rosewood Hotels support the NGO Room to Read, who help Cambodian girls continue their education in Siem Reap.
Next up, coming in at number five, traveling halfway around the world and arriving in Namibia.
It was the first African nation to write protection of the environment into its constitution. That can mean safari adventures here are relatively pricey. But your money goes to a good cause, helping to protect wildlife, support local communities, and prevent poaching.
Last but certainly not least, Scotland.
Large parts of Scottish land are being rewilded thanks to the efforts of the European Nature Trust. They remind us that spending time in nature is good for mental health, stress relief, and physical well-being.
Yes, you'll probably have to fly to visit most of these places, and that ain't great. My stance on plane travel is if you must fly, make it count. Make responsible choices in your travel provider and explore with purpose. I'm not saying it will always be easy, but nothing good ever is. Here's me trying to give a go with some staycations in the UK, or if you prefer, here are some cat videos. Thanks for watching.